you know, as a Muslim. Alhamdulillah, today we have the honor that Mas Agus has to travel so far away to visit us. And as all of us may know, that he's been, I think it's been doing the pengajian here, right, before. So we can learn a lot of things from him, inshallah. It's not only about the plan. So he's also very good in our deen and religion, so that we can learn together to get our all of us get better. So welcome Mas Agus to our humble masjid here, and we're very blessed to have you here. So inshallah we can learn and make use the knowledge that you share with us. So in today's event, we'll talk about the topic is the unity of the Ummah. Is some a topic that will be very useful for us to strengthen our Ukhuwah Islamiyah in Atlanta and the and surrounding areas to all of us, you know, so that our blessing will come down to us when we all get together, and then for us to prevent, you know, from the temptation of the Satan. When we get together, you know, we will be stronger. Bersatu kita teguh, ya. Bercerai kita runtuh. That's how Indonesia. That's the smile. Teguh smile. So without further ado, I would just read. We don't have that many, you know, like a protocol or whatsoever. So today we're gonna do Quran recitations that will be recited by Brother Sadiqin. Masha'Allah, he's our resident, permanent resident of this masjid. He's the truly masjid boy or masjid man. Yes, he's truly, he's living here, he's serving 24 hours to the masjid, masha'Allah. And after the recitations, solidity, the translation too? The surah is Surah Al Imran, verses
102 to 105.
Yeah, from Al Imran, verses 102 to 105. And then you're gonna read the translation too? No? Okay, I can read the translation for you. Or not, you can read the translation so that we can share the ajar. Right, and then we will continue with the speak from Brother Agus about the topic, and inshallah we'll conclude with you know, have a very nice meals that been prepared at the back. That's okay. Inshallah we will start, and then let's straighten our niyyah. You know, that we gather here is to learn something about Allah Deen, so that we can all the barakah. Let's start with the Bismillah. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. And Brother Sadiq, that's for you.
Thank you, Jazakallah khair. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا واذكروا نعمة الله عليكم إذ كنتم أعداء فألف بين قلوبكم فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَتِهِ إِخْوَانًا وَكُنْتُمْ عَلَى شَفَا حُفْرَةٍ مِنَ النَّارِ فَأَنْقَذَكُمْ مِنْهَا كَذَلِكَ يُبَيِّنُ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ آيَاتِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تهتدون ولتكن منكم أمة يدعون إلى الخير ويأمرون بالمعروف ويأمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر وأولئك هم المفلحون ولا تكونوا كالذين تفرقوا واختلفوا من بعد ما جاءهم البينات وأولئك لهم عذاب عظيم.
Dengan menyebut nama Allah yang Maha Pengasih dan Maha Penyayang, kami berlindung dari godaan setan yang terkutuk. Hai orang-orang yang beriman, bertakwalah kepada Allah sebenar-benar takwa kepadanya, dan janganlah sekali-kali kamu mati melainkan dalam keadaan beragama Islam. Dan berpeganglah kamu semuanya kepada tali atau agama Allah, dan janganlah kamu bercerai-berai. Dan ingatlah akan nikmat Allah kepadamu ketika kamu dahulu atau masa jahiliyah bermusuh-musuhan, maka Allah mempersatukan hatimu, lalu menjadilah kamu karena nikmat Allah orang-orang yang bersaudara, dan kamu telah berada di tepi jurang neraka, lalu Allah menyelamatkan kamu daripadanya. Demikianlah Allah menerangkan ayat-ayatnya kepadamu agar kamu mendapat petunjuk. Dan hendaklah ada di antara kamu segolongan umat yang menyeru kepada kebajikan, menyuruh kepada yang makruf, dan mencegah dari yang mungkar. Merekalah orang-orang yang beruntung. Janganlah kamu menyerupai orang-orang yang bercerai-berai dan berselisih sesudah datang keterangan. Maha benar Allah dengan segala firman-Nya.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin. Wa bihi nasta'inu 'ala umuri dunya wad-din. Wassalatu wassalamu 'ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa 'ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Amma ba'du. First of all, we praise and thanks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the blessings that we have, including the blessings that we have today. Alhamdulillah, this is the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we all meet together in this place. This is the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we have a good condition, healthy condition, to come here to have this halaqah. Inshallah, to learn a little bit about the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And salawat and salam to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, our beloved Prophet, to his family, his companions, and also to his followers, including us. Amin, amin, ya Rabbal Alamin. So inshallah, today we're going to talk a little bit about what happening in this world. Okay. So this is Indonesian language or?
Indonesian. You can mix.
Okay, I'm sorry brother if I mix with Indonesian's language. So, what happening right now in this world? We know there are many problems, especially that problems that now we face as a Muslims in many places, not only in Gaza, not only in Palestine, in other places. And we wonder why Muslims are so weak. Why Muslims are so weak? We cannot defend ourselves. We see there are so many people that can do anything to Muslims, to Islam, as if we don't have that strength to try to fight it back. So what happened? What happened? Sometimes we wonder, yeah, we said, but also if we go back to the Quran and also the Hadith, as Sunnah of Rasulullah, we know that this thing will happen. This thing will happen. This is what we call the Nubuwat. I believe, I follow this Ikhmiyah pengajian. Maybe several weeks ago, you know, Ustadz Marjuan talk about Nubuwat. Nubuwat, what is Nubuwat? Nubuwat is the prophecy. The prophecy that Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said 15 years ago that something will happen on the future. This is not prediction. This is not prediction. This is will happen, would happen. When he said it, it will happen. Because he said it, it will happen like that. This is what's called the Nubuwat. And Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is not magician. He's not what you call the dukun or whatever that saying that something will happen and then this is different. No, this is not prediction. This is what we call the Nubuwat. It is happening right now. What Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said long time ago, 15 years ago.
15,000.
Oh, 15,000, thank you very much. Not 15 years ago. 15,000 years ago. That's 15 years ago is just...
15,000 years ago.
15,000 years ago. I'm sorry. The one that give me the... The music, the whisper is not much correct either. See, I just follow what he said. 15,000 years ago. No, it's 1500 years ago. Okay, it's correct. Make sure. Prophet Muhammad SAW said 1500 years ago that this thing will be happening. We do not follow the order of Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. Basically, why it is happening? You know, our brother Shadiqin, right? Yeah, he say he reads the Surah Ali Imran. Okay, start 102, but the translation start 103. So in Surah Ali Imran, this is Surah number 3, or chapter 3, ayah number 103. Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala said, this is an order. Wa'tasimu bihablillahi jami'a. Wala tafarraqu. That's very clear. It's very clear. Allah said that holds in the rope of Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala, which is in the true fact, in the deen of Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala, together jamia, and never ever wala tafarraqu, never ever divided. Keep united. I think Kentucky have that motto. United we stand, divided we fall. Yeah, that's the motto of state of Kentucky. Yeah, that's Indonesian motto actually. Yeah. Bersatu kita teguh, bercerai kawin, bercerai kita runtuh, fall, jatuh. That's actually, I don't know which one copy, whether Indonesian copy Kentucky or Kentucky copy Indonesian motto. We don't know.
There's some Indonesian like that.
Yes.
Kentucky copied Indonesian.
Yeah.
A lot of things that they take from Islam.
Yes.
Yeah. And they put their own stamp on it.
As a law, yeah.
And yeah. Say, oh, this is what I come up with. No,
yes.
1,400 years ago, Quran already said.
Yes.
Father Simubi Hamdulillah Ibn Yah.
Yes, yeah. Under one God. One God with trust, right? That's Indonesia is called it.
Yeah.
Under one God, we follow. We only worship one God, actually. That's the motto of Islam, actually. Under that, the motto of all the prophets, because Islam is actually not for the followers of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Islam is for the all the followers of the prophets. Islam means someone that submit and worship only to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that all the prophet, they have the same father, but different mothers. So the sahabat asked, what does that mean, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? It means that all the prophets, they carry the same message, one father, which is carry the same message. What is that? Tauhid. All prophets carry the Tauhid. Worship only one God, the true God, the God. That's the reason why it's called Allah. Allah is coming from Ilah with Alif Lam. You know, if you learn Arabic, if you put something in the noun with Alif Lam, it's become the, become definite. Okay, but Ilah mean Tuhan, God. But Allah mean the God, the only God. Okay, so that's the meaning of Allah actually. Yeah, Alif Lam is a make, that's a definitive noun. Okay, so Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that all the prophets have the same father, which is carry the same message, Tauhid, worship only one Allah. But they have different mothers. What does that mean? It means that the same message, one Tauhid, but their Shari'ah, the way they do it, are different. In the time of Prophet Adam, for example, you don't have to salat. There is no fasting. You just believe. That's your religion, Islam. And then in the time of Nuh, the same. They actually don't have to worship. I mean, there is no special way how to worship. They just believe it. That's already Islam at that time. And then going down after Prophet Moses, Isa alayhi salam, and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Shari'ah become better, perfect. Because what? Because we need it. That Shari'ah is for us, not for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's help us to make us, you know, in this world right now, if you do not perform salah, for example, your life gonna be very difficult. Right? Because you're gonna lose connection with Allah. You're gonna lose guidance if you don't do it. But in the time of Prophet Nuh, maybe you don't need that worship, you know, the prayer 5 times, daily times, and etc. No. Because just worship, just believe, that's enough at that time. That's what Prophet Muhammad SAW explained about the same father and the same mothers for all the prophets. Now we go back to our topic about teguh. Ya, bersatu kita teguh. So why it is happening? Why it is happening? Because we do not follow the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this, what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, will happen. It will happen. It will. Definitely will happen the time like that. When people, the Muslim, they are so divided. They are not connected. Even just a little bit things, like Indonesia right now, we have the presidential election, right? If you choose number one, your wife number two, you fight. you will not united. I am number one. I am number two. No, we fight. Even that, because that's the thing that actually what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it will happen. It will happen. Like in one hadith, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Yushiku antada'a alaikum al umam." One time, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there will be a group of people. Al-Umam is a group of people that hate Islam or Muslim. They will work together. Right? They will to work together to attack you, to come to you. alaikum, ya, al-umam. Kama tada'a al-aklatu, ya, seperti, tahu, seperti. Like, you know, people that ready to eat, ya, ala qas'atiha. Like a people, the eater, that ready to eat, they come together, they ask their friend to come together, let's go eat, go to our festival, our feast. Party, our feast. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So that's like, that's what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. One time, there will be a group of people, they don't like, they hate Islam, they don't like Muslim, for example, they will come together, they will work together to attack you, to defeat you, as if there are a group of people that coming with pork and spoon ready to eat. And they invite their friends to come to eat you. That's the similarity that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned. One time it will be like that. One time it's going to be like that. And then one sahaba asking Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, awa min qillatin bina ya Rasulullah, yawma idin ya Rasulullah, will we be very few in number at that time, at that day, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Qal bal, no, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, innakum kathirun. You at that time, at that day, will be majority. Kathirun is not only a lot, it's very a lot. You just you know, Japanese people say if this is banyak, it's just banyak, but very banyak is banyak. Wakeh, akeh is a lot, right? Wakeh is
A lot.
Okay, we can say that. In you can change that, you know, American language a little bit. It is just a lot. It's a lot, but it is so many. A lot. That's kathirun.
A lot.
It's happening right now. You know how many Muslims actually in the world? Billions. 1.7 billion Muslims, as you know, if the Christianity they divided between Catholics and Protestant, Muslim is actually number one in the world in numbers. 1.6 billion. You can imagine that. Billion, a lot. And then how many Muslim country, what we call a Muslim country, is majority Muslim, is almost 70 maybe countries, close to 100 countries actually majority Muslim, but they cannot do anything because that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this is nubuat. Something will happen at that time when you are a lot, but you just like, you know, the food that people coming. You just like a buoy. What is buoy?
Buoy.
On the ocean. Yeah. You have no strength at all. And people do not afraid of you. At that time when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that, Muslim is only maybe several thousands, less than 100,000, but nobody want to attack Islam, Muslim at that time, because even though they are small, They are very strong. Nobody want to attack with it. Nobody want to mess with Muslim at that time, in the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because they are very strong, even though their number is very small. But now, we are very big in number, but we are very weak, basically. So people can do whatever they want to Muslim. Now when the companions ask Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, why? What is the reason? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allah nazzala bikum al-wahan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put disease in your heart is called al-wahan. What is al-wahan? Hubbud dunia wa karahiyatul maut. This the disease in the heart, which is hubbud dunia. What is hubbud dunia? Habibi, if habibi mean love, okay? So it's hubbud dunia. Love dunia, love worldly life, and wa karahiyatul maut. Makruh, makruh mean dislike. What? So they dislike death. Okay. Sometimes, you know, Muslim is a little bit confusing when he said, anybody here want to go to paradise?
Yes.
Raise your hand.
Yes.
Who want to go to paradise?
Yes.
Anybody want to die?
Don't want to die.
See? That's contradictory, I mean. You go to paradise after you die, you will not. You want paradise, that what you don't want to die. That's contradictory. Paradox, yeah. Impossible. Okay. So, this is the two things that make people, Muslim especially right now, they become so weak. Because what? They are hubbud dunya. That's the first. They love this worldly life. They love this worldly life. And they don't want to die. They want to enjoy this life as many, as much as possible. As long as possible. If you have a long life, you know, but your goal is akhirah, that's okay. I mean, it doesn't follow this rule. I mean, you're not really hubbud dunya, okay? Because even though you have a longer time, the longer time actually from Muhammad SAW, the best people, the best person is the one that tall in umur, long in umur. In their age, but they have more hasanah in their life. Okay, the longer your life, the more hasanah. That's the best. Prophet Muhammad SAW, the best person. Longer life with longer hasanah, more hasanah. Okay. So, this is the things that we have right now, and why it is happening. What is the signs of the hubbud dunya? We can ask ourselves. We have it. We have that sign. Yeah? What's the first sign? The first sign, the one that have hubbud dunya, is that their goal is mainly worldly life. The goal mainly worldly life. Even they teach their children to love dunya. You know, you can ask yourself. Sometimes you ask your kids, what you gonna be when you growing up. What you gonna be? I want to be a doctor. I want to be
lawyer.
Engineer. I'm gonna be a lawyer.
What if it makes a lot of money?
That's right, money. The goal is dunya. The goal is money. Even the school, you know, sometimes the teacher, you know, they ask the kids, yeah, the students. They say, yes, Udin. We have Udin over here?
No.
No, alhamdulillah. So we don't have, I can use Udin. Okay, the teacher asked Udin, Udin, what is your goal? What is your, objective, the goal after when you are growing up? And the Udin say, I want to be a doctor. Right? I want to have my own hospital. I want to build a big house for me. I want to have a good cars, not only one, but many cars. Right? Cars, not wife, okay? Cars. I want to that. Oh, the teacher said, very good, Udin. That's a very good goal. That's very good cita-cita. In Indonesia, we call cita-cita, right? We call it your cita-cita, your dream. What is your dream? Okay, that's good, Udin. Right? And then the teacher asked another student, let's say his name, is there any Fatima over here?
No.
No, okay, so can you see Fatima? Fatima, what is your dream? What is your goal? Easy, teacher. When I'm growing up, I want to marry Udin. You don't have to work hard. It's already there.
Yeah.
So, but still, okay, still, what we teach our children right now is mostly dunia thing. Sometimes we don't realize it, but we have that. We have that. I have that one also. Sometimes I talk to my kids, our kids, what gonna be, and sometimes we compare this one. Okay, this one have a more salary, this one is less salary. If you become this, then you gonna that, you gonna this and that. If you marry this man, if you marry that man, right? Sometimes we have that without we realize it. Yeah. So that's okay. I mean, if you have that goal, but you also have to prepare yourself and the children also to have a goals in the akhirah. So not only the dunya, because Islam do not prohibit you to have dunya. No, you know Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam say the best Muslim is the one that is strong not only in their physical but also in their wealth, because they can help more with, they can do more with the wealth. Even Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there are three types of jealousy that you can have it. What is one of them? You can be jealous to someone that have more money, but he spend it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's a good jealousy. You can be jealous with that one. It's okay. Yeah? As long as you don't want, you know, him to be bankrupt or whatever, you know. As long as you're jealous for that person and they want to be him, want to be like him, have a lot of money, but for what? To serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to have more sadaqah, to have more involvement in the community. That's the best. Which is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the best person is the one that benefits to others. Yeah. That's the best person. If we will be able to benefit to others, that's the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam really praise. And alhamdulillah, this masjid is not only, I believe it's not only benefits Muslim, Indonesian Muslim over here, but benefits others. Because in Islam, you don't, you know, just don't choose special that, you know, making it inclusive. It will have to be excellent. Even though, of course, we have to organize the place. You cannot just give it to someone to, you know, to control the place, because sometimes it's not that, you know. So we can control it, we can organize it, but we make this available for people, not only for specific group of people. That will make that unity. So that's the first sign of Hubbud Dunya, which is what? The goal is mainly for dunya. Okay? So we have to change that. Yes, it's okay to have a goal for dunya, but also we have to have a goal for akhirah. Walal akhiratu khairul laka minal ula. The akhirah actually is better than this dunya. So if we can make it a little bit higher, the goal for the akhirah, that's better. It means that you have money, spend it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have car, drive it to the Hikmiyah Masjid. Okay? Not only to the mall, okay? Use that wealth. You know, use that car to benefit you in the akhirah, not only in this dunya. Inshallah. Okay? The second sign of Hubbud Dunya is the person that have Hubbud Dunya, they usually don't want to pay charity. Or it's very difficult to, you know, give charity. Not only charity, even zakat, that is obligation for them, they don't want to pay. If they pay it sometime, they calculate it very, very strictly. 2.5%. It's too much, you know. They make it as much as close to 2.5%. Right? That's okay. I mean, that's okay. But sometimes if you have that 2.5, is actually not really the limit. This is the lower limit for paying your zakat. If you have more, you can give more. Even the time of Muhammad Sallam, some people pay 20%, which is 1/5 of their money, yeah, for zakat. They say, I want to give my zakat 1/5 of my money. It's not the minimum. So the sign of people that have that Hubbud Dunya, they love their money, even for the obligation thing, they try to make it as minimum as possible, just to, you know, to meet the minimum amount. That's I'm okay, I'm done. Sometimes we don't know. Maybe your calculation is not that correct, right? You put 2.5, but the money that you use for calculation is actually more than that. You make it minimum thing. You take it from, okay, I have to spend for my family first. I have to grocery first. Blah, blah, blah. And finally, what happened? It's a very minimum amount. Usually, you know, the minimum amount for maybe in the United States for paying zakat is maybe for 5,000. If you have money in your bank for 5,000, then it is obligation for you to pay zakat. Right? 2.5 of that 5,000. If you have more, then time that money that you have in the bank. No, you gonna calculate. Okay, I have to spend for my my kids, tuition, whatever. Finally, what happened is lower than 5,000. Sometimes it doesn't make sense. You know, sometimes it doesn't make sense. People that have a big house, big car, you know, and then they don't pay zakat because after their calculation, the money in the bank is only 3,000. And they are not obligated to pay zakat if they only have 3,000. But some people try to make it as minimum as possible. Sometimes it's lower than the minimum amount for zakat. Just that's the second signs of hubbud dunya. They love their money, they don't want to spend it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They don't want to spend for charity and sitwa. If you really love your money, actually, you have to take it to the grave. Right? Because what? Because the money that you have in this dunya will not give you benefit at all in the akhirah. Your money in the dunya, if you let it, sometimes it's become what? Because the source of fighting between the kids, between the children, between the relative, right? But the money that you spend is actually the money that you carry to your grave. This is the one that benefits you. And this is your own money. As long as you're still alive and you have money, you can spend it. You can bring it to the akhirah, you can bring it to the graveyard, which is spend it as much as possible to the charity, pay zakat on time, and so on. Because that's the one that benefits us. Not the one that we left. You cannot bring your car to the to the grave, the house to the grave. Yeah. So that's the second sign. The third sign, the someone that have the hubbud dunya, they usually very greedy. They are very greedy. Wailul likulli humazatil lumazat alladhi jama'a malahu wa 'addalah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that celaka, woo to the people that, you know, saying something bad, and also they counting their money, you know, always, you know, check their account. Okay, my account. That's who, the one that always counting. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in that surah, actually. They think that their money will stay there. They think the money will help them with everything in this dunya. That's the third sign. Right? They don't want to lose their money. They count it every time. And what happened? It's actually make them stress. The money should, you know, protect us, right? But instead of the wealth protecting us, for these people that have hubbud dunya, they actually become the protector of their wealth. Right? They always worry if there is someone that will take my money. They always check that. That's the greedy. And sometimes, because the greediness, they don't care how they get the money, because they are so greedy. It's happening a lot in many places. Corruptions, bribery. You know, in Indonesia, we, you know, several months ago, we see how, even though he already have a very high status in the
government,
they still doing that. They have enough, actually, without that corruption. But because they are so greedy, they do it. They don't care about halal or haram. They mix between halal source and the haram source. Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that even though that this is the characters of human, even though they have already have one mountain of gold, what happened? They will ask another one. They have two mountain of gold, they will ask the third one. And continuously, that's the greediness. That's the sign of hubud dunya. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from this disease, the al-wahan disease. I'm sorry I cannot be longer because, you know, I have to travel back to Kentucky. I have to teach tomorrow morning. So it's still about 7 hours back to home. So maybe I will be there around midnight. Okay, so if you have a question, I just, inshallah, stop here, you know, and I can going give it back to Mas Teguh. If there is some question or maybe comments, inshallah.
Alhamdulillah, jazakallah khairan, Mas Agus. So, it's really shared an insight, like open our horizon, how to look this thing and trying to stay away, you know, from the description of people that love hubud dunya with al-wahan. So, if there's any questions that we want to discuss with regard to this discussion, to the topic, please go ahead.
Yep.
A question?
Usually, if there is no question, there are two things happening. First, it's very clear; everybody understands.
Clear.
Yeah. Second, everybody very confused. They don't know. I have the first one.
Number one.
Alhamdulillah.
Clear,
mashallah.
Waalaikumsalam.
As regard to the unity.
Yes.
There are hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in which he emphasized on the leadership.
Yes.
And he emphasized on having a khalifa,
yes.
Mm-hmm. Having an imam. But for political reasons, these days, those countries especially which call themselves Ahlul Hadith, they are the ones who suppress a hadith like this that instigate Muslims to have a khalifa. We should all make dua,
Ameen,
to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us an imam,
yes,
or a khalifa.
Yes.
Without it,
yes,
nothing will happen ever.
Yes, yes.
And about the hubb ad-dunya, mm-hmm, in Surah Fajr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَأَمَّا الْإِنسَانُ إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ رَبُّهُ فَأَكْرَمَهُ وَنَعَمَهُ فَيَقْبُلُ رَبِّهُ. When Allah blessed people, human beings, with His ni'mat, they'll say, Allah, subhanallah, Allah, alhamdulillah. وَأَمَّا إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ فَقَدَرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقَهُ. When He tests them and make their rizq tight, فَيَقُولَ رَبِّي هَانًا. He says, oh, Allah has insulted me and Allah has put me down. No. Then Allah says, Kalla, Kalla Balla Tukremuna Yateem. No, it is not. Because you are not respecting the Yateem, Yatama, Walla Yahuddu Allah Ta'amil Miskin. And you are not arranging food for those hungry people, Masakin, they did not have anything to eat. This is what we have to all keep in mind. Quran is a book which has solution for everything, yes, and answer for everything. Quran is telling you what to do. Take care of the yatama, take care of the masakin.
Yeah, that's a noble words again. So we also, even though this is a bad or difficult situation, we have the optimistic what Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, and one day also there will be leader that lead the Muslims
to fight this injustice, which is start with the what we call the Imam Mahdi, and then continue with Prophet Isa alayhi salam, Jesus peace be upon him, that he will return back to this dunya and it will lead all the Muslim, the Islam. So that's also nubuwat. And alhamdulillah, even though Prophet Muhammad SAW this time is the when people is in difficulty because there is no unity, you know, between the Muslim, but still we have to do our effort to make as many as possible, as fast as possible, united in our area, in our place. Yeah, even though he said that Prophet Muhammad SAW actually, you know, made a dua to Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. Two of this dua is actually given by Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. But last one, Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala don't really give the, you know, answer for that one. What is the first one Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam asked to Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala? He asked that this Muslim become the majority in this dunya. Yes, he gave it. Second, make Muslim become wealth, a lot of wealthy Muslims, right? Yes, Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala said yes, you will have that in one time. Then the future Muslim will be like that. But the third one, when Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam asked for the unity for the Muslim, and Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala don't really answer that dua. It means that yeah, this is a kind of the way that happening in this dunya. The Muslim, you know, they keep divided, but one time it will be united again. Now Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala give us the ability to make our community stronger, you know, strive for the unity together and make give the benefit for all peoples.
Amen.
Amen.
Is that
part
for?
Yes, sure.
Anyone else? If not, I have some.
Yes.
Okay. It's like.
Ya, ya, maaf, saya masih bisa kok bahasa Indonesia.
Seseorang menurut saya itu nggak benar, tapi saya tidak langsung bilang, tidak langsung mengatakan kepada orang-orang tersebut bahwa saya tidak seperti itu, dengan cara saya diam, karena saya punya saya mengerti betul tentang bahwa diam itu adalah lebih baik. Tapi ada beberapa orang juga yang bilang lebih baik dijelaskan untuk semuanya itu clear. Kalau saya bersikuku untuk tidak menjelaskan karena akan melebar lagi gitu masalah itu.
Tidak mau menyatakan.
Apakah itu dibenarkan? Karena saya lebih baik memilih itu.
Okay.
Lebih baik dia. Entah itu yang mudah-mudahan memang tidak benar. Karena kan kadang objektif ya. Menurut kita itu belum tentu orang lain menurut orang lain benar. Yang penting tidak terlalu fatal kesalahan itu. Jadi saya lebih memilih untuk diam. Bukan berarti saya menerima semua tuduhan itu, karena saya memang sudah kadung punya apa cara seperti itu dari dulu.
Okay.
Nah, ini saya tanyakan diperbolehkan tidak?
Okay.
Ya itu satu. Yang kedua tentang tadi Ustaz sampaikan bahwa kita ngumpulin harta lebih baik apa lebih utak goalnya itu tentang dunia, urusan dunia, sementara urusan akhiratnya mungkin nomor dua. Itu saya rasakan Ustaz 10 tahun saya ditinggal single mother. Saya ingin membahagiakan anak-anak saya. Terus saya mikir salah nggak ya, seperti yang Ustaz bilang sampai kayak itu tadi, benar ternyata untuk sedekah aja saya kok masih ngitung-ngitung gitu ya, padahal umur mungkin tinggal kapan gitu ya, udah tua gini mau kapan lagi saya untuk anak-anak saya gitu. Tapi ada kecemasan gitu Ustaz tentang anak-anak saya ini. Nah itu bagaimana apa yang harus saya lakukan? Apakah saya sudah ya memang ini hanya itu aja. Saya masih memilah-milah antara sedekah dengan membahagiakan anak-anak. Karena mereka dalam kurun waktu sejak kecil sampai sekarang tuh ya menurut saya alhamdulillah, cuma saya ingin lebih lagi gitu membahagiakan mereka. Tapi ya itu tadi, sampai kapan ya saya harus seperti ini? Kapan saya mau memikirkan akhirat saya, tabungan saya gitu Ustaz. Jadi dua itu, satu diperbolehkan enggak saya mengambil sikap untuk tidak menjelaskan, untuk lebih baik diam daripada saya harus ngomong gitu kan, harus oh enggak saya enggak tahu atau gimana gitu Ustaz ya. Terus yang kedua tentang gimana caranya untuk biar dua-duanya tuh
seimbang
antara saya membahagiakan anak-anak saya, keluarga saya, saudara saya dengan urusan tabungan saya kelak di akhirat.
Bagus tuh question.
Assalamualaikum
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Ini pertanyaan saya pakai bahasa Indonesia ya.
Karena
pertanyaan bahasa Indonesia, saya jawab Indonesia. Ini pertanyaan yang sangat bagus ya. Dan memang ini kenyataan ya, dalam hidup itu memang ada pilihan. Selalu ada pilihan. Ya. Nah, makanya kita sebagai manusia dikasih hati dan mind dan otak ya untuk memilah-milah itu. Gunakan keduanya, jangan gunakan satu-satu, karena kalau gunakan satu-satu nanti hasilnya tidak maksimal. Jadi gunakan logika kita dan juga gunakan hati kita untuk mengambil keputusan. Nah, masalah apakah diam atau kita terangkan ya, dua-duanya benar, artinya mana yang kita ambil tergantung situasinya. Jadi dalam bahasa Indonesia itu diam adalah emas gitu kan. Kalau bicara apa berarti ya? Perang. Jadi tergantung situasinya. Jadi pernah cerita ya, ada di Quran bahkan ya. Ini sangat sangat cerita yang sangat jelas, yaitu satu-satunya cerita Nabi yang tuntas dari awal sampai akhir. Tahu enggak cerita Nabi siapa itu yang satu-satunya tuntas ceritanya dari awal sampai akhir dalam satu surat?
Musa.
Ya, Nabi Musa itu ceritanya di mana-mana, di mencar-mencar.
Yusuf.
Ya, surat 12. Nabi Yusuf. Itu ceritanya lengkap itu. Dari awal, dari dia masa kecil, anak-anak diceburin ke sumur sampai dia grow up di Egypt ya, kemudian dipelihara sampai pembesar di Mesir. Kemudian sampai menjadi pembesar Mesir, sampai dia membawa keluarganya Bani Israel itu kenapa ada di Mesir, karena dibawa sama Nabi Yusuf itu kan. Itu lengkap. Nah, salah satu cerita dalam surat itu ya, Nabi Yusuf ini sebagai ini buat kita ya, itu adalah Nabi Yusuf pernah dituduh. Ya, dituduh sama siapa? Sama ibu angkatnya sendiri. Ya, dituduh apa? Berbuat asusila. Bukan susilo ya. Asusila. Berbuat yang tidak senonoh. Ya, pada saat itu apa yang dia lakukan? Ya. Dia mencoba menjelaskan, tapi akhirnya dia pilih diam. Bahkan dia memilih untuk tinggal di penjara. Ya. Jadi pada saat itu karena kondisi tidak memungkinkan, ya lebih baik dia diam. Jadi kalau memang kondisi tidak memungkinkan, situasi tidak memungkinkan, diam nggak masalah. Ya, mungkin kita punya pemikiran kalau saya lawan, kalau saya terangkan malah jadi ramai misalnya. Diam, yang jelas yang tahu kan Allah Subhanahu wa taala. Kita serahkan pada Allah Subhanahu wa taala. Yusuf pada saat itu langsung minta pada Allah Subhanahu wa taala, selamatkan saya dengan masukkan saya ke dalam penjara. Dimasukkan ke penjara. Tapi setelah keluar dari penjara, Yusuf mulai mempunyai kekuasaan. Apa yang dia lakukan? Sebelum dia menerima jabatan sebagai wazir di atau menteri di Mesir itu, ya, dia minta kepada raja Mesir, ya, bersihkan dulu nama saya. Bahwa saya masuk penjara ini karena fitnah. Karena bukan saya, kesalahan saya. Jadi langsung Raja Mesir itu memanggil siapa? Zulekha sama suaminya, ya, yang mantan ibu dan orang-orang tua angkatnya itu ke istana, ya. Kemudian Yusuf kasih tahu yang sebenarnya itu seperti ini, ya. Saya itu digoda sama Siti Zulekha, yang benarnya seperti itu. Saya ingin dikelirkan itu dulu sebelum saya menerima jabatan sebagai menteri Mesir. Langsung rajanya bilang, benarkah seperti itu? Nah, saat itulah Zulekha langsung mengakui bahwa benar, yang bersalah adalah saya. Jadi Yusuf itu hanya difitnah. Jadi kalau memang ibu yakin bisa menerangkan, ya, atau meng-counter berita itu, ya, dalam suasana yang baik tentunya, itu silakan aja di-counter. Tapi kalau memang ibu punya berpikiran bahwa kalau meng-counter itu malah lebih jelek hasilnya, ya diamkan saja, nggak masalah. Karena itu nanti juga kalau diam pun itu bisa menjadi amalan kita di akhirat nanti. Ya, Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam bilang akan datang, ya, kamu kalau akhirat nanti orang yang suka mengfitnah itu, ya, nanti dosa-dosa mereka itu ya, pahala mereka akan diambil oleh orang yang difitnah. Kalau pahalanya enggak cukup, dosa-dosa orang yang difitnah itu akan dilemparkan ke orang yang suka memfitnah itu. Jadi kalau kita diam pun, ya, kita punya harapan bahwa Allah Subhanahu wa taala akan membantu. Kalau memang bisa diterangkan, ya, supaya clear, ya, diterangkan. Jadi dua-duanya benar, bukan yang diam yang benar, bukan yang menerangkan, tapi dua-duanya benar.
Kalau diterangkan masih enggak mau ngerti.
Ya biarkan aja, artinya didiamkan. Ya,
kalau sudah kan, dilakukan.
Ya, kalau sudah dilakukan, insyaallah. Itu yang pertanyaan pertama. Yang pertanyaan kedua,
sodako.
Ya, jadi gini. Jadi masalah goal dunia dan akhirat itu di Islam sebenarnya gampang aja sih. Di switch aja, gitu loh. Di switch. Artinya gini, ketika kita melaksanakan sesuatu, maka dalam Islam itu, ya, setiap langkah baik kita, setiap perbuatan baik kita, mulailah dengan apa?
Bismillah.
Setiap kamu berbuat baik, ya, mulailah dengan bismillah. Karena apa? Bismillah itu akan mengubah dunia jadi akhirat. Bismillah itu akan merubah dunia menjadi akhirat. Jadi kalau ibu misalnya spend buat anak-anak, ya, tadinya pengen buat tuition, buat membahagiakan anak-anak gitu, tapi ini masih dunia gitu, ya, dengan dirubah dengan bismillah, itu nanti niatnya akan niat akhirat. Jadi menyenangkan anak-anak itu, kalau dengan bismillah, pahalanya kita dapat. Karena apa? Karena kita dengan nama Allah, kita ingin membahagiakan anak kita. Bahkan Rasulullah SAW bilang, ya, harta terbaik yang kamu berikan, yang kamu spend itu adalah kepada keluarga. Jadi keluarga dulu, ya, kalau memang kita cukup punya untuk keluarga, ya spend untuk keluarga. Itu yang paling baik. Harta yang paling baik adalah harta yang kamu berikan kepada keluarga kamu. Itu yang pertama. Yang kedua, sedekah yang paling baik, kata Rasulullah, adalah sedekah yang kamu berikan kepada relatif. Relatif itu apa itu? Saudara-saudara. Ya, extended family. Itu sedekah yang terbaik. Karena apa? Kata Rasulullah, kalau kamu bersedekah kepada saudara-saudara kamu, itu kamu dapatkan dua. Apa yang pertama? Ya, pahala sedekah. Apa yang kedua? Silaturahim. Kekuatan silaturahim tersebut. Jadi kalau kita mampunya sedekah, misalnya, itu usahakan dulu sedekah kepada keluarga terdekat kita. Kalau ada lebihnya, kita bisa berikan ke tempat yang lain. Jadi itu, ibu, ya, mungkin mudah-mudahan ini bisa menjawab. Jadi bahagiakan anak-anak kita itu kewajiban, ya, kewajiban. Jadikan kewajiban itu menjadi tujuan akhirat dengan apa? Bismillah. Setiap kita melaksanakan sesuatu, bismillah, itu jadi akhirat. Kita makan misalnya, kita makan tanpa bismillah, itu cuma untuk dunia aja itu. mungkin menyehatkan kita, yang membuat tubuh kita bagus. Enggak ada akhiratnya. Tapi begitu kita bilang bismillah, apa yang terjadi? Makanan itu menjadi berkah, menjadi akhirat. Jadi gampang dalam Islam sebenarnya ya, untuk merubah dunia itu menjadi akhirat gampang. Bismillah. Ya, seperti tadi saya bilang, kalau kita menasihatkan anak kita, ya anakku, ya, ya silakan ambil mata kuliah misalnya jadilah dokter. Ya, jadilah dokter, insya Allah ketika kamu menjadi dokter, kamu bisa bermanfaat untuk orang banyak. Bismillah. Bismillah. Punya cita-cita sendiri. Bismillah. Karena tanpa bismillah itu enggak ada apa-apanya, enggak ada artinya. Apa yang kita lakukan tanpa bismillah enggak ada artinya. Mungkin mendapatkan hanya di dunia, di akhirat nol. Dengan bismillah, insya Allah, Rabbana atina fid dunya hasanah wa fil akhirati hasanah. Dua-duanya dapat bismillah. Jangan lupa bismillah. Keluar rumah bismillah. Sebelum tidur bismillah. Semua yang kita lakukan yang baik-baik bismillah. Kalau kita belum tahu doanya, maka dalam Islam setiap langkah itu ada doanya kan. Mau makan bacanya apa? Bismillah. Allahumma barik lana fima razaqtana wa qina adzabannar. Kalau belum bisa, belum apa ya bismillah. Kalau udah selesai makan, alhamdulillah. Mau keluar rumah? Bismillahi tawakkaltu. Mau tidur? Bismika Allahu. Semua bismillah itu. Wah. Apakah bismika, bismillah, Allahumma, itu bismillah itu. Menjadikan dunia menjadi akhirat, merubah dunia menjadi akhirat. Mudah-mudahan ini bermanfaat, karena mudah kok. Jangan dipersulit lah agama itu, jangan dipersulit. Bismillah, insya Allah menjadi akhirat.
Alhamdulillah, terima kasih kepada Mas Agus. So, jadi takeaway-nya apa hari ini?
Dari
bismillah. Ya tentunya apa namanya, apabila kita very eager, terus topiknya itu memang relate dan kita merasa perlu waktu, jadi kayak gitu aja. Maksudnya kan sebentar aja gitu Mas Agus. Jadi tapi kita ngerti lah Mas Agus harus traveling back to Kentucky. Insya Allah ini tidak berhenti di sini Mas Agus ya. Sering-sering lewat, nanti kapan-kapan kita udah di sini juga gitu insya Allah. Jadi kita semua memang sangat merasa manfaatnya ini. Kalian lihat di wajah-wajah ceria kan ibu-ibu semuanya. Bahkan dibilang tadi sedekah keluarga ke istri, wah itu udah malas mana semua itu. Jadi alhamdulillah ya, jadi kita hari ini tercerahkan, terutama ibu-ibu yang tercerahkan gaya hari ini. Ya jasa kemarin Mas Agus, semoga kita dapat berjumpa lagi. Amin. Baik di majelis di sini atau majelis yang lain, tapi kita masih selalu kepingin belajar ke Mas Agus untuk apa berdiskusi dengan agama ini yang akan mencerahkan hati kita, melapangkan hati kita sehingga hidup ini lebih ringan untuk menuju ke Allah.
Amin.
Dan semuanya menjadi tadi apa namanya dunia pun hasanah, akhirat pun hasanah, alhamdulillah. Dan karena waktu kita tutup dulu acara hari ini, dan Mas Agus minta tolong untuk baca doa buat kita dan sekalian ditutup majelis Mas Agus. Insyaallah.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Marilah kita berdoa. Let us pray to Allah Subhanahu wa taala. Not only for ourselves but also for our family, our friends, our brothers and sisters in many area in the world, insyaallah. Al-Fatiha. Alhamdulillah, insyaallah, rajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahirabbil alamin. Ar-Rahmanir Rahim, Maliki Yawmiddin. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. Ihdinash shiratal mustaqim. Shiratal ladzina an'amta 'alaihim, ghairil maghdubi 'alaihim waladdallin.
Amin.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. نستغفر الله العظيم نستغفر الله العظيم نستغفر الله العظيم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين رب اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وارحمهما كما ربيانا صغارا رب اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولإخواتنا وأخواتنا وأدخلنا في رحمتك وأنت أرحم الراحمين رب اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولجميع المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات ويا قاضي الحجات إنك أنت السميع القريب مجيب دعوات Allahumma fir lana, Allahumma fir lana wali walidina warhamhuma kama rabbayana shighara. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما رب اجعلنا مقيم صلواتنا ومن ذرياتنا ربنا وتقبل دعاء ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم اللهم انصر الإسلام وللمسلمين والمسلمات في فلسطين وفي كل مكان اللهم انصر الإسلام وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات في فلسطين وفي كل مكان اللهم انصر الإسلام وللمجاهدين في فلسطين وفي كل مكان اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداء الدين ربنا آتنا من لدنك رحمة وهيئ لنا من أمرنا رشدا ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك سلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته
I think we can have